This video is going to go over the Lightroom print module. With the print module, it's laid out in the same way the other modules are. On the left-hand sidebar are pre-existing elements, such as the templates. They have pre-existing templates, and you can create your own. You also have access to collections, which makes sense, since you'd probably be printing from them. In the center is the layout of your current paper, and on the right sidebar are a set of panels. The top one is the layout style. We're going to be using single image contact sheet. If you use picture package, that would be well suited for things like weddings or school photos. So we're going to go back to single image. Right below there is image setting. And zoom to fill means that the image will fill the current existing cell size. Rotate to fit works if you are using some horizontal images, some vertical images. Rotate to fit will make sure they all are in the correct orientation. Then we have stroke border if you want to add a little width to it, and you can increase that width and also select the color in that little box right next to it. Below that is the layout, and I'm going to access the guides just to show you what the layout looks like. You have the ability to set margins. Those margins go onto the pre-existing paper. So you want to make sure that the paper size you're using has no existing margins, and that way you can custom set them in this panel. Below that, we have a page grid, which sets up multiple rows and or multiple columns, allowing you to print more than one image on a page. The cell spacing refers to how much space there is between the images, and you can make that choice if you want to have space between it vertically or horizontally. We also have the cell size, which can be controlled individually. Below that, we have guides. These are non-printing. They just show you where the edges of the cell are. And you have choices. You can add in background colors. You can put your own name on top of the images. For the most part, we're not going to be using them. We're rarely going to be using this photo info. We are going to be using this bottom panel called Print Job. And you have the choice of printing either to a printer, depending on which printer you have loaded, or you can print to a JPEG file. For the diptychs, we'll be printing to JPEG file. With printer, you have the choice then of the print resolution, how much sharpening, whether you're printing to glossy or matte. Under color management, that is where you would load the profile for your printer. Let me now go to JPEG file. Your file resolution, once again, your print sharpening, media type, you don't have to worry about that too much. How much compression you want on your JPEG. And once again, your profile. If you're going to eventually be using this to print, then you'll want to stay with Profoto or Adobe RGB. If you're creating this to go online, then you'll want to be in sRGB. And generally we use perceptual. At the bottom here, we have a button, print to file. Notice that when I change this dialog to print, then that button changes to printer. The last part of this is setting up custom page sizes. Over on the left-hand sidebar towards the bottom, page setup, and you click under paper size. Go down to Manage Custom Sizes. You can click to create a new one. It'll come up untitled. You want to then name it. And it's always good to double check that these are done correctly, because You never know if the last person actually changed these. The big thing that you want to do is zero out all of these bottom margins. That gives you the ability to control it on that right-hand sidebar. And then simply say OK. You'll notice that it's listed there. Say OK, the paper then changes. And those are the basics. If you've selected more images than will fit on one page, you'll actually see it listed down towards the bottom right side, and it'll say page one of however many you're using. And that's the print module.